small camp geek squad. I'm pretty sure it's been a week or maybe two since I last uploaded Percy Jackson vs. Katara Part 1. Well, today we're going to carry on with the powers section. We've got two sections in this. We've got their powers and then their combat skills slash skills. Powers is going to be broken down into their hydrokinesis, healing, amps, their variety, and others. So for varieties, it's not other powers. It's more like how many varieties they have. For example, someone can have two different powers, you know, types of hydrokinesis type thing, but they could be more powerful than someone who had many. Anyway, we're going to start off with hydrokinesis in the power section, and we're going to start off with Percy Jackson. Now, Percy has done many insane feats when it comes to this. At 13 years old, just by saying the word wave, he created a wave to drag a ball into the sea. That was age 13. He was not affected. He's not affected at all from falling long heights from into the water. He can stay dry and dry things off. He can create an air bubble underwater to help others breathe. Underwater, he is so fast that when other people have their ears pop or anything like that, he can just keep swimming, and he's probably the fastest swimmer in the water in this universe, out of the demigods at least, maybe even out of some of the monsters. He created a giant water hand to hold on to the Gorgons who were trying to fly away, and then created a whirlpool to stop them reforming, and all this without breaking a sweat after already being injured. And that's the majority of these feats are after being injured. He can shoot water up three stories high. He can sink ships, and he did so when he was 17. He can blow up water cannons, well, with ease. He can create water shields that can protect him from projectiles thrown at him from two river gods. Bear that in mind, this is river gods. He can support several tons using water. He can control water from half a mile away. Magical rivers, sweat. He can also do many other things like control other things, but we're not going to get into that. Pretty much, he's not... There was only one type of water we've seen him struggle to control, and it turns out not to be water. But that's complicated. But he's been able to control water whilst facing water gods, and has been able to beat the giant who was made in order to defeat Poseidon, Percy's father. When it comes to using hydrokinesis, Katara is able to contain fish. She's in a bubble of it. That's less of how powerful she is, but shows she's got control to control it. She can hold back a deluge sludge type substance to hold someone in place. If you remember, that was the Basing Se with the drill. She can propel herself up and down things using water. She creates water whips to fight. Also uses blast jets. She can knock a man out with a water whip, though for how long is unsure. She can use ice shields, water shields. She can match... Her water whip can match Zuko's fire whip. She can down two men. She can also down a reptiles with a wave of water. She can use streams, rain, sweat, flowers, and also blood in order to control... to get water. Well, his blood, she does blood bending, which is another form, which we'll get into in a little bit. And we'll also get into it in the overall, because that is a big important factor of this fight. She can also slice metal, but where Percy's been able to blast up open pipes and toilets and take down very big things with his water, as you know, She's been able to more... She's more precise with slices. But if you remember the thing of Ba Sing Se, she's unable to fully slice through it, even with Aang's help. She can also block fire with the water. Now, in my personal opinion, with this factor, I know I don't normally go over it all here, but this is an important factor. I think Percy Jackson's more powerful and raw in terms of his hydrokinesis and control over water. Whereas I think Katara's very powerful, but I think she's more versatile and more controlled over her abilities. She can create whips, she can create octopuses, things like that. And, you know, it's more of a flowing movement where Percy's more just, you know, like blasts of attack. And I think his is more powerful, but I think hers is more precise and flowing and things like that. Now, we're next gonna... So, in terms of hydrokinesis, I think Percy Jackson takes the vat. I know most of you will be like, but you just said hers is more controlled. I think hers is more controlled and more precise. But I don't know if that will be able to compete with Percy's raw power. Next up is healing. So, in terms of healing, Katara can heal other people pretty well. I mean, a lightning strike to Aang's back took her a while to heal, and she had to use special healing water. But this is special healing water, and this was no ordinary lightning strike. It kind of disaligned his chakra, so it was more than just a normal injury. It was also, I think, a spiritual injury as well, so there. But she's been shown to be very proficient in healing others. But on the other hand, Percy Jackson can heal himself. And this is the hugest factor in the fight. It's a one-on-one fight. He can heal himself with water. So he can either put water on himself to heal himself, and it gives him an amp, which we'll get onto later. And Katara can heal other people, but I'm not sure, we haven't seen if she's able to heal herself. And this factor pretty much means most of her attacks will be useless. If she keeps using water to attack him, he'll just heal and get amped. That's why in the healing factor, Percy wins this. In a group fight, it might be slightly different. And in terms of amp, as I said, it's Percy. Katara doesn't have any amp. You know, she has the rage amp, but Percy has the rage amp. But he also has the amps where everything, his speed, his strength, his durability, all this just increases tenfold when in water. So I think he wins that too. He wins the three factors so far. Now, in terms of varieties of their powers, I would say this is a draw. Now, the reason I say this is a draw is simply because Percy can he can bend poisons and things like that. Katara could ice bend and blood bend. Percy can control water and poisons and gases and things like that. Anything, and he's shown to be, if it has liquid in, he can pretty much bend it. And in terms of others, Percy wins. He has other means of attacking, in other words, another variety of powers, you know, the strength, the speed, the reflexes. I know that's not considered a power, but they are powers. He is superhumanly quick, strong, etc. So I know we spoke about them, but they do count as other powers. And he can also control the ground, shakes. But his main ability is water. So overall, in terms of power, Percy Jackson wins with his first dropped point, if you will, where he draws instead of winning. Now, so far, that does mean that Percy Jackson has won both physical and mentality and now powers. So yes, most of you will assume he's won, but that doesn't necessarily mean he's won. if Katara is way more skilled than he is, like a shit ton more skilled than he is, she might be in with a chance. So let's get started, shall we? Now, the final thing we have is combat skills slash skills, as I just mentioned. In terms of this, this will be broken down into skills. So the skills will be how good he can combine everything we've mentioned previously. His powers, his physicality, his mentality, his attacking and defensive skills, alternative ways of fighting, etc. Defense, attack, they're going to be the two other categories. And the last category is going to be alternatives. So this is if they have alternative methods of fighting. Now, in terms of skills, I think Percy wins hugely. Because I think while she's a very... while Katara is a very agile and quick reflexes, mainly reflex fighter, you know, her reflexes, reactions are very good. She's very good with controlling water and attacking, and she's fluid. She's like the water tribe's meant to be, equal on the attack and defense, and can combine them all, which is very good. I think Percy, he's fought gods and titans and giants, and he survived. In he at 13 years old, he went into the underworld, you know, that the Greek version of hell. He fought through there, he survived. He survived going in the River Styx, and he's survived being in Tartarus, a place which literally kills anything that's not a monster. And he was able to survive all this by fighting and thinking his way through. He can... Now, one of the things I'm going to add on here is teamwork. And I think Percy is better at teamwork. And I'm going to say this because he's a leader. He's the leader of the group. Him and Annabeth are always kind of the leaders. But he's the one you want to rely on in a pinch. You know, if things get tough. He's the powerful one. He's still somewhat intelligent, as we've mentioned. And he can combine his knowledge that he does have, his fighting skills. He can, you know, his sword fighting, his powers. He can combine them all really well. I think Katara's very good at this, but I think Percy wins this. He can just combine and he has so much more to offer. And I think he works better with his team. They all bounce off one another where... Katara seems to rub heads with her team, so the teamwork lets her down a bit. And I just think while she can flow back and forth, which is very good, I just think Percy overall can add more together. But yet again, this is a close one. This is a close one. In terms of defense, this is where I've got Katara winning. Only because she's more fluent and a lot of her things are more reactive, but... And Percy doesn't seem to do much defensive. But I'm going to put this as a win by Katara because she does more of it to a very high degree. But I'm going to say similar to with their powers, I think Percy, his water shields are more are stronger because they held up to gods, two river gods and titans and all these things. And he's fought against them. But he doesn't really defend himself. It's mainly his main tactic is dodge and attack. But having said that, this is very close, and in my mind, I'm flipping over this right now. Now, in terms of attack, I'm going to say it's Percy, no doubt. He can attack. His whole fighting style is aggressive. It's attacking and dodging, and he overwhelms them. He is strong, he's quick, he's very skilled at fighting. He's the best swordsman in his universe, really, out of the demigods. The only one that was better was Luke, but Percy became better over time because Luke died. Spoilers. And anyway, I think it's just Katara is a balanced fighter. Attack and defense, attack and defense. Percy, there's yet to be an opponent he hasn't really been able to properly beat. He may have lost to some temporarily, but he's never lost for long. So, having said that, it has to be Percy. Now, in terms of alternatives, Percy has all his water abilities, his powers, his hydrokinesis, the healing, the amps, which gives him an advantage. He has the mental resistance, which gives him another advantage. He can fight hand to hand, but that's like he barely does that. He fights mainly with his sword and his powers, and his hydrokinesis, which is yet again, as I've stated before, more than Katara can have. But then you've also got the varieties of powers. She can bloodbend to use ice, use water. He can shake the earth, even though he barely uses this. He can use his water powers. He can use his sword. He can also control poisons. He can also turn things to ice and turn water solid and things like this without turning it to ice. There are so many more things he can do with his powers, and I think he can attack in more ways, and he has more alternatives, and he's one of the most skilled swordsmen, as I said before. So he wins that. Now, what does this leave us overall? Well, we'll see that right now. So overall, how do I think this fight is going down? Well, I've got to say Percy dominates, in my opinion. While Katara is a very skilled, very powerful, one of the most skilled and most powerful and respected fighters in her universe, in the Avatar universe, and has done some very impressive feats and fought some very impressive people, as you can tell, she does not compare to Percy Jackson. She doesn't have the physicality, the mentality, the powers, all the skills to keep up with him. Now, so yes, overall, I do think Percy Jackson wins. Now, in case you're wondering how I think this would go down, I think this would be done within a matter of seconds, potentially in less than 60 seconds, and that all depends down on one factor. If it happens in less than 60 seconds, it's because Anyway, the sword can only hurt demigods. Now, if it can hurt Katara, it's done in a few seconds. And the reasoning is, all of her attacks will just boost him to begin with. She'll throw a water attack at him when they first meet, if they were in a fight. He would take it, he would take it because he'd be shocked, and he would want to be refreshed. It boosts him, and then I think he charges in, and while he's running in, surprising her that it's alarmingly fast, I'd say probably like Ty Lee level, something like that, she will probably then throw more and more water. It won't do anything. He'll dodge, he'll redirect it at her. She gets hit, gets sent back. She'll throw ice and might cut his cheek, but before she knows it, he's run the sword right through her. She's dead. End of. But if that doesn't work, then I think it'll be ended by Percy Jackson, either by, with longer, taking a few minutes. Either he overwhelms her with the water attacks, and when she starts to ice attack, he'll probably start doing a few back, and she'll just won't be able to take it, and all her water attacks, he'd be able to take all her ice attacks, he'd be able to take so much of it that she wouldn't be able to put him down. But I think he would be too quick. He would be able to dodge and deflect all of the ice attacks and even redirect them before they hit him. And I think it'll only be like a few five in the whole fight if it lasts from a minute. Probably, I think, a minute to 10, depending. I think he could win in a fist fight if he got close enough. I think he could pummel her. But I think the more interesting fight that we'd all like to know is, if it was a slightly longer fight and they both got angry. If they both got angry, both got amped. He would have a few cuts here and there, maybe from a few hits, maybe a little bit tired, and she would be more injured, more tired. She would attack him with water again, or ice. He would turn it into water, heal himself and become faster. Every time he was physically close, he would start throwing punches and hurting her. But she would probably end up moving back, dodging, or putting an ice wall, giving them space between them. And I think mainly it'd just be her using all her water whips and ice attacks and all her skills and fluidity, and he would just dodge and overpower all the attacks getting through them. And then if she threw water, he would throw water, he would use a water attack on her. She would put up her water shield or ice shield, and I just think he would overpower through that. Obviously, her shield's taking some of the defense off it, and I think if he ever wanted to put up a water shield, it would take everything she has to offer, and it would generally be her skill and versatility, just his power and power. And then I think it'll get to the point where he's winning, she's bruised, she's struggling a little, she's slowing down because of it, and he just he seems to be getting better and better. He just seems to be staying the same as he was, if not getting better because of all the water ramp and the anger now boiling through his body. So I think he will start dominating her, and when she feels like she has no choice, I think she will bloodbend him. And this is really what it comes down to. Bloodbending, people say Katara wins, Percy can't do it. But I think Percy could do it. He's been able to overpower poisons from beings older than gods, from giants who turn water to poison. And he's been able to overpower gods with his water. And I think he'll be able to realize what's going on as she's doing it. So that's when he takes up most damage. And I think he'll control himself, get back in control. And I think this is when the two most brutal things in the fight, and most interesting probably, and less likely to happen, would happen, where she would throw water at him. He would just send it right back around her face. So she's struggling to see and slowly drowning. And as she tries, and as she goes, and then she'll bend away briefly, but he'll overpower it again, then start to bloodbend her till she refuses. And then I think either he'll calm down and remove the thing, keep her bloodbended still though, and talk to her, and then they find out they're not against each other. But if this is the anger you see him using in Tartarus to control the poison, and Annabeth's the only reason I stopped, then I think he'd either kill her with a violent snap of the neck, or bloodbend her so all the blood in her body stays still and force the water down her throat, killing her. I think that's the more brutal way, but as I said, I don't think he'll go that far. I think if the sword affects her, he wins in less than a minute. If he doesn't use the sword, then I think it'll take one to 5 minutes max before he wins, because he's just quicker, stronger, more agile, and his powers are just more. And the only way she can hurt him is with ice, but he can turn that into water and he can easily dodge those projectiles. Now, before I go, I'd like to say, if you have any requests for verses, this can be other characters from Percy Jackson and Avatar, so it could be Zuko versus Annabeth, Appa versus Miss O'Leary, Percy versus Aang, the teams versus the teams, etc. Or it could be people, Marvel characters, DC characters, Dragon Ball characters, any character that you can think of, horror, comics, shows, anything like that you'd like me to do, please let me know in the comment section below. I'll try and do them. If I don't know them personally, I will do my research before doing them, as I do want to make this a somewhat regular thing on my channel, the verses. But as I've said previously, please leave a like, comment what you'd like, share this video, and try and subscribe. I want to get to 50 subscribers before the start of the next year. If you do so, I'll do a Q&A as a New Year's special, only if I get to 50 subscribers before then. I'm currently on 38. I know you guys can do it, so please help me with that. If you have any questions for the Q&A, leave it with a hashtag Q&A or just Q&A, and then leave your question so I know it's there and I won't answer it. If you have any other questions that you don't want to be in the Q&A, questions below. Thank you guys so much for watching. Till next week.
Hugo, I've scared you. I've said too much. I'm hopeless and awkward and desperate for love.